Hello, everybody. I am temporarily stepping in for my man, Fletcher. And my name is Travis Harlan. I am one of his teammates from the UMFK basketball team. And we're here on this lovely day of September 20th to watch our UMFK Bengals play. Goals. You guys are goals. Let's go, Willie. I'm excited to see this game today, like I am for all the home soccer games. I enjoy watching our Bengals play against other teams. Like I said before, I am pretty excited for this game. See the outcome. Congratulations to our Lady Bengals on the 11-0 victory.
Hello and welcome to the University at Maine at Fort Kent. We're bringing this USCAA men's soccer matchup to you all the way live. My name is Fletcher Brown. I'm here in the booth. It's homecoming weekend, second game of a doubleheader. You're listening to a Bengal Vision live webcast. We've got the Fisher Falcons from the Boston, Massachusetts area. They've traveled up here to Fort Kent to take on your Bengals. And the game is on. We want to thank you for tuning in today to this live webcast. It's a pleasure to be bringing this game to you. It is a nice sunny day here in Fort Kent. As I said, it's homecoming weekend. second game of a doubleheader, our women's team, our Lady Bengals, defeated the Fisher Falcons 11-0. So the men are looking to also get the victory today. The Bengals starting off pretty well. They've already had one early chance down towards the goal. They're in possession now. Well, not quite as now right as I speak. But they're looking to maybe not put 11 scores on the board. That's a tall order, but they're definitely looking to put their mark on this wonderful homecoming weekend that the Fort Kent community has experienced. Friday was our pep rally where the student body and the Fort Kent community, including lots of alumni, were able to be introduced and meet and greet all the athletes, including both men's and women's soccer teams. Saturday, which was yesterday, we had the homecoming parade through downtown Fort Kent, which was a really nice event. All the athletes lined up and were handing out pencils and candy to bystanders. We had lots of local businesses like, you know, the Lakeview Restaurant and local organizations like a dance troupe and the Girl Scouts, where they had floats as Kalusha's striking down the left side, crosses it. But the keeper for the Falcons wraps it up. So that was yesterday's parade. That was a nice event. After the parade, we had the alumni soccer game, which gave UMFK alumni a chance to lace them up one more time and compete against our men's team. And today, we've got our doubleheader. The Bengals coming off a home loss to one of the top teams in the USCAA in West Virginia Tech. But Coach Ashby had them hard back at work this week. A long week of practice in preparation to play against this Fisher team. They're looking to respond to try and get their stock back up to make it to the national tournament. And I'm confident that they came into this game prepared to come out with the victory. They've tasted defeat, and they didn't like it. I know they're hungry to get back on top and start another streak of victories. It's been a pretty good pace so far in this game. We're about 5 minutes in. Both teams have had opportunities close to their goals, but it's still 0-0. However, it is early. Jamie Reed with a nice pass to Kalusha, but he was called for offsides. That one was borderline. However, doesn't take away from the fact that it was a beautiful pass from Jamie Reed. O'Dean with the header, able to take that pass away from the Falcons. Jamie Reed is in control now. Stephen Al-Said, the young freshman from Scotland, which is associated with England over there in Great Britain. He's getting a lot of early minutes from Coach Ashby. He's definitely a major contributor to this Bengal unit. Even though he's just a freshman, Coach Ashby knew what he was doing when he was recruiting our Scottish team members. They're some of the major contributors to the success of this Bengal program as Kalusha in this left corner looking to make something happen. Passes it back out to Stuart Conway with the cross. Nobody there. Rodney Witter, another freshman. He's from the island of Jamaica. So we got two freshman starters in our lineup for the Bengals, which is not particularly rare, but it is interesting with, you know, not a lot of people graduated or left last year's unit, which made it all the way to the USCA National Championship. So they had a lot of returners. Willie with the header just off the mark. But that just goes to show that Coach Ashby's an excellent recruiter, as he's got two freshmen getting lots of playing time, even though he's got a deep roster with lots of talent throughout. Kalusha left side, evading two Falcon defenders. Maintains possession for a minute, although 2-on-1, he couldn't quite control it. Stuart Conway, nice save to keep that one in bounds to Jamie Reed. Ooh, Stuart Conway fakes out a Falcon defender. Nifty move there. Looks like the Bengals are going to reset. Willie into the out of bounds. The cross from Steven negated by a Falcon header. Keeper for the Falcons. Busy already early in this game. 36 minutes remaining in the first half. I have a feeling that now that the Bengals are starting to load up on the time of possession, I think this keeper for the Falcons is going to have his hands full today. Out of bounds as Bengals retain possession. Steven outside with the corner kick. Bengals are always dangerous off the corners as they have a little bit of height down there with Ben Kluvers and Rodney, Kalusha. Tom Coxon's kind of tall. They can use their height and their vertical, try and make something happen. Ross evading defenders. Cross is a little bit too strong to Steven. Trying to see what he can do. Ben Kluver's lefty strike, no good. As the Falcons finally bring it out from outside their own goal. Looking to advance the ball, trying to get something started early. But this Bengals defense is incredibly strong as they get the ball right back. Rodney to Willie. There was open field in front of him, but the referee calls him for offsides. Deep ball for the Falcons into the 18 for the of the Bengals, but Odine's all over it. Out of bounds in that far left corner, the only spot on the field where you can see any shade. It's a beautiful day. The sun is shining down on the field. Not too windy. It's a great day for a soccer game. It looked pretty cloudy this morning. I was wondering, man, is it going to rain? That put a little bit of a damper on the doubleheader, but Mother Nature was on our side today. We've got the first foul of the game called by the referee. Let me see if I can figure out what happened here. Falcons getting ready for the kick. For the cross. No good. Two Falcon strikers were right there, but neither of them could connect. The pass was right there. But a little bit of miscommunication from Fisher College as they missed a golden opportunity to be one-on-one with our keeper for the Bengals today, Alex Charette, Fort Kent native. It's nice to see Alex back there in goal representing Fort Kent, especially since it's homecoming weekend. Coach Ashby opted to give him the start today. And he was, I could tell in pregame, he was eager to get rolling. Willie faking out defenders all over the field as Kalusha switches sides to Steven. The strike deflected by number 8 of Fisher as he hits the deck. Nice hustle by that young man. We've got Ben Kluvers, El Capitan to Ross, just left of the net. Another nice opportunity for the Bengals. They're doing well so far. They're getting the opportunities. They're just taking a little while to warm up, maybe. Nice pass from Steven. Not sure if that was a shot attempt or a pass. Kalusha was right there for the header, but nice leaping catch by the keeper for the Falcons. Able to keep this game at a score of 0-0. Falcons now with the ball. They had one opportunity a few minutes ago to score, but it was to no avail. Tom and Willie play catch. A takedown by a Falcon defender. No call by the ref. Nice, hard, clean play. As Willie is called for offsides again. This Falcon defense is doing a good job at creating a little bit of a trap there. And that's the third time Willie's fallen into it. It's a good tactic by the Falcons to try and do something to keep this aggressive Bengals attack to a minimum. Can't blame the craftiness of the Falcons in that regard. Willie turning on the nitrous. Ooh, couldn't quite get to that one. When Willie decides to put his head down, he's like a speeding bullet. He can just get to where he wants to go in a hurry. Ross Downey bobbles it. Right side. Strike! Finds the back of the net. He didn't quite have it initially, but he wheeled it back around to that right side where he was able to use that powerful right leg to put the Bengals ahead early here. 28 minutes left to go. Ross Downey with the goal. 1-0 Bengals. Steven, another nice pass, but Willie and Kalusha both caught offsides there. The Bengals are going to have to find a better way to try and work the ball in to the 18 because that's the fourth or fifth time they've been called for offsides. Speaking of being offsides, Willie Stout now starting to question the referees, a little bit puzzled. Like I was saying, the Bengals are going to have to find another way to get the ball, you know, get some shots on goal because the long crossing passes aren't quite working. This Falcon, you can tell that the Falcons have thought about this game plan ahead of time. Ross. Borderline offsides again, but he couldn't find the mark with that right foot. Running full speed, a little bit of a tough bounce. Ross couldn't quite knock that thing in there. As Rodney intercepts that pass. Willie on the right side. Between defenders. Ross, another shot just left of the goal. That's the third shot that he's had a good chance at. He's 1 for 3. 33%. Falcons looking to advance the ball. Jamie Reed playing tenacious defense as he comes up with the stop. Now Willie. Ben Kluver's right side. 3-on-2 for Ben Kluver's. Rodney. Deflected by the keeper for the Falcons. That was a fierce strike. Quick instincts by the keeper to stop that goal from scoring. Rodney. After the header, he let it bounce up so he could time it right, but he was just high. And the Bengals are starting to rack up shots on goal. Doesn't look good for the Falcons. This Falcons defense is working right now. We've got a foul. Kalusha, a little too aggressive. Falcons with possession. Offsides from Fisher College. Ross Downey to Kalusha, left side. He's going to reset it. Stewart, nice pass to see if Ben can make something happen here. Twirls around, but with four Falcon defenders on him. He wasn't able to find the mark. Stewart, another nice crossing pass. Header from Ben to Willie. As the keeper comes up to deflect that one, even Willie had to give that man his props. Gutsy play, rolled the dice by leaving the net empty, but it paid off as Willie went with the header, but he's called offsides again. So the Willie offsides tally is at 1-0. Maybe Coach Ashby should come up with some type of tally. You know, 100 push-ups for every offsides, maybe something like that. But then again, you don't want to discipline aggressiveness. But like I said, this Falcons team is definitely prepared for the Bengals' aggressiveness. They've set up this little defensive trap there. We've got a substitution for the Bengals. LaSalle and Kyle Robin have entered the game with 22 minutes left in this first half. Coach Ashby looking to shake things up. LaSalle and Kyle Robin entering the game for Rodney and Jamie Reed. Like I said, Coach Ashby looking to shake up the lineup. Maybe get some new blood flowing in there, some juice. Try and see if either of these two new insertions into the game can make something happen. I think that the Bengals have been right there, and although they are winning 1-0, they've had lots of opportunities, so maybe a substitution can get them over that hump, so to speak. Kyle Robin surveying the field. He finds Ross. Nice stop by number 6 of Fisher, but Kalusha takes it right back. left corner into the shade for the Fisher Falcons as Steven knocks that away from his opponent. Fisher retains possession. They throw it in. Alex Charette to insert the ball into play. 19 minutes left here. In case you're just tuning in, you're listening to Bengal Vision live webcast of Fisher College Falcons against your University of Maine at Fort Kent Bengals. This is USCAA soccer action live from Alumni Memorial Field here on the campus at the University of Maine in Fort Kent. It's homecoming weekend. This is the second game of a doubleheader. Men's and women's soccer action here on this Sunday. The Bengals, the Lady Bengals, defeated Fisher College by a crazy score of 11-0. It was all Bengals all game in that one. So far, with 18 minutes remaining in the first half, the Bengals are winning 1-0. Ross Downey scored the one and only goal of the game. Willie hurdling the keeper for Fisher as that keeper once again took the risk of leaving the net empty. Kyle switching sides, Steven on that far right side. The defender was trailing him the whole way. He wasn't able to get a clean pass off. Bobo advances the ball, trying to find Ross a little bit too strong. Fisher College into Bengal territory. See if they can make something happen here. Trying to respond after being scored on. Got a little bit of a lull in the action. Nope, we don't. Fisher College. Lofting pass. Nobody was there. We've got a substitution. We've got Garth and James. James Blanchett coming in for Ross and Willie. The amazing thing about the Bengals unit here is that they are deep at every position. They've got versatility and they've got talent up and down the roster, so there's not a lot of drop off when Coach Aspie makes substitutions. As Stuart Conway with a beautiful pass to Kalusha Heads up play by number 8 for Fisher and number 30 for Fisher to combine on getting that stop, as Kalusha wasn't able to make anything happen after coming across two Falcon defenders. But what I was saying is that, you know, even when Coach Ashby makes substitutions, there's no drop off in the energy, the chemistry, or the communication, because he's done such an excellent job recruiting everybody. You know, he's recruited talented players from all over the world, and all these players have bought into the team first mentality. No player on this team thinks he's better than bigger or better than the team, than everybody, you know, the unit as a whole. And that's led to their success, as Kalusha went for the strike, deflected off a Fisher defender, and the keeper reels it in. But that unselfish and selfless mentality has led to a lot of recent success for the Bengals. Coach Ashby finds guys who want to win, and they don't care about individual accolades, as a shot on goal by number 15 from Fisher College, Alex Charette, diving to his left to make an amazing save. Fisher College slowly but surely starting to make a few more advances towards scoring a goal. Bengals are going to have to come up with some insurance goals pretty soon here. Ben clears it to Kalusha. The strike's deflected. Ben to Garth. Trying to track it back down from a Falcon defender. Tom Coxon all over it. Good ball from James, had some potential, but found the Falcon defender. Stewart lofts it up. Ben off the crossbar. Just a bit high. Excellent opportunity for the Bengals. That darn crossbar. What is that thing doing there? Pretty nice crowd here for this second game of this doubleheader. Shout out to everybody who's stayed tuned, who's been staying in tune with both games of this doubleheader on the Bengal Vision Live webcast. We really appreciate your support. Thank you for watching. Garth to Kalusha, evading defenders. Nifty footwork. Deflected. Two shots in a row deflected. Excellent work by Kalusha to find himself. He dribbled right into the teeth of the defense, but he was able to find an open shot. Couldn't quite knock it in. But regardless, excellent job trying to get himself open there. Lucia Stewart. Nice play by Alex. Great hustle. It was a foot race with a Falcon striker, but he turned on the jets and was able to kick that one back into play for the Bengals, negating a potential chance for the Falcons. Kyle Robin up to Kalusha, nice pass. Mano y mano with a Falcon defender as the rest of the players come in and James loses it. Number 15 for the Falcons, kicking it down to Alex in the goal. Was hoping some teammates would be there, but they were not. On the same page. Garth, wide open. Another excellent chance for the Bengals. They are right there. It won't be soon until they open this one wide up, wide open. Another offsides for the Bengals. We've got a foul on the play. Number 19 for the Falcons takes a spill. Hobbling a bit, but he looks as if he's okay. Number 13 from the Falcons. Looking to set something up. All he finds is Bengal defenders. Steven racing down the far sideline. As we've got another foul. Six minutes left in this first half. The game is flying by. 1-0 Bengals. Ross Downey scored an early goal. But the Falcons have been keeping the Bengals' attack at bay. The Bengals have certainly had a number of opportunities to crack this lead wide open, but for one reason or another they're just a bit off. Alex didn't even have to move to reel that one in as he rolls it out to Stewart. 5 minutes remaining in the first half. You know the Bengals are desperate to score one or two more before the end of the half. Number 19 for the Falcons, evading three Bengal defenders. Kyle with a quasi bicycle kick. As a Falcon called for the foul. LaSalle keeping it alive, finds Kalusha. Cross. No good. The keeper for the Falcons is working really hard today. He's doing a pretty good job considering that he's had his hands full. Takedown from Kyle Robin to get the ball back for the Bengals. Tried to switch sides there, but too much power behind that leg. Adjustments to be made at halftime. Not a lot to say. It's one of those tough games where, you know, you're right there, but you just got to add that extra bit of focus to get the job done. Bobo's aggressiveness on full display as he takes that away from a number 19 of the Falcons. Excellent job. He was scrappy on that last altercation there. He really wanted to get that ball back for the Bengals, and he was successful. Offsides one more time for the Bengals. 2.5 minutes left in this first half. Flying right by. 1-0 Bengals, homecoming weekend, second game of the doubleheader. We haven't quite had the offensive array that the first game, the women's game, had, but this has definitely been a little bit more of a chess match. Both teams playing not quite to a complete standstill, but it's been back and forth action. Whereas in the first game of the doubleheader, the women's offensive prowess was on full display. Garth and the keeper for the Falcons collide after James's nice crossing pass. Hope everybody's okay up there. They both seem to have gotten up just fine. One minute remaining in this first half. Let's see if the Bengals can make something happen here. Try and stretch this lead out before halftime. Lofts up a cross. Keeper for Falcons reels it in. The first few minutes of the upcoming second half are going to be crucial for both teams. If the Falcons can keep the Bengals' attack to a minimum, they might have a chance to come back in this game. And the Bengals are going to look to be aggressive to try and stretch it out to start sealing the deal early in the second half. as some... The Bengals and the Falcons coming face-to-face here. Action is starting to heat up as the first half comes to a close. I don't know about all you listeners at home, but I'm certainly looking forward to the second half of this one. It's going to be a hotly contested matchup. It's currently halftime. Please stay tuned to this Bengal Vision Live webcast. We'll be back for 100% live commentary on the second half. Stay tuned. And we're back. We are back here at Alumni Memorial Field for the start of second half action. We've got the University of Maine at Fort Kent Bengals against the Fisher College Falcons. Fisher College made the 8-hour drive up from the Boston, Massachusetts area. The score right now is 1-0. Ross Downey was the lone goal scorer of the game.
Ross is on fire. Last game, he was the
lone goal scorer for the Bengals. And thus far in this one, he's the lone goal scorer.
Certainly having a good season this year.
Definitely.
Maybe Ben right here will pick it up too. Last season, I believe, he scored about 30 goals.
Impressive. He's the captain. He's a leader. I know he wants to get on the board as Fisher Falcon just completely boots it out of bounds, basically giving it to the Bengals as Alex Charette enters the ball in a play to Steven Saeed. Al Saeed. Coach Ashby going back to the starting lineups to start this second half.
Thank you. Always a fun time.
It's homecoming weekend here in Fort Kent. Want to let all you global listeners know, in case you are just tuning in, you're listening to a Bengal Vision live webcast of today's USCAA men's soccer matchup. The Bengals, in their last home match, their 55-game home unbeaten streak was snapped at the hands of two-time defending USCAA national champion West Virginia Tech.
One hell of a game.
It was definitely an entertaining one, much like the one we have in front of us today. The Bengals were hard at work this last week of practice as Stuart Conway takes a spill. Foul called on the Falcons. The Bengals were hard at work during practice during this last week to try and possibly start a new streak of home success. Their first opponent in the new era of home unbeaten streak is this Fisher Falcon team. Right now it's 1-0, and the Bengals in the first half had lots of shots on goal. They had plenty of opportunities. They just could not find the mark on a majority of them. The keeper for the Falcons has done an excellent job. And just as I say that, Kalusha with a nice cross.
Great work, Kalusha.
Who tapped that in?
I believe that was Rodney who tapped that in.
Rodney.
So we've now got the score at 2-0. And just as I mentioned at the end of the first half, the Bengals were going to be looking to be aggressive early in the second half to try and, you know, put their mark on this game and stretch out this lead a bit. And that's exactly what they've done so far.
Willie bringing it up. Oh, he goes down. Oh.
Jamie Reed received the pass from Willie, but it was too high on the shot there. My mistake, everybody, for all my listeners across the world, that last goal was deemed offsides.
Indeed, a disappointment. Offsides.
So my mistake, I was wondering why, number one, the scoreboard hadn't showed the correct score. And number two, there didn't seem to be much of a celebration on the field from the Bengals. So my mistake on that one, the score remains 1-0.
Not just showing their humble side, I suppose.
Yeah, I was I was honestly thinking, I was like, wow, they don't seem very happy that they scored. Maybe they're just really trying to get back down to business.
Taking a page out of the Patriots books, no celebration dance.
But there was no celebration dance because there was no celebration.
All right.
So the Bengals, however, I did mention that they were looking to be aggressive, and they have been doing that.
Keeping it on the correct side of the field.
At the end of the first half, I noted that, you know, it's tough to make adjustments in this game because it's been solid action. The Bengals have had lots of opportunities. I wonder what Coach Ashby told them to get them, you know, keep them motivated in the second half. Probably just gave them some parting words of advice about maintaining focus. And if you, you know, continue to keep chipping away at the Falcon defense, they're going to crack eventually.
Hard to do on this lazy Sunday, especially coming off of that tough loss.
Yeah, but they're doing their best so far. For the Falcons, they've got to be happy with the effort that their defense has been giving. They've only given up one goal. But they're going to need to step it up offensively. They have not really had the ball too much. They certainly haven't gotten it on the other side of the field very often. So they're going to have to change that up, which is also just a testament to the defense of the Bengals. Any glimmers of hope that the Falcons have had have been shut down as the header from Tom Coxon had a chance.
That Falcons goalie has been on his A game today, no doubt.
Yeah, he's been giving out an outstanding effort.
We should talk to our stats man, Kostas, figure out how many shots on goal we've had so far.
Yeah, we're going to try and get that to you guys, but it's up there.
Steven, Rodney.
Rodney, nice job of keeping that away from a midfielder for the Falcons.
Nobody's letting this get out of bounds.
Ben Kluver swoops that in for the interception.
Ben back to Steve. Steven moving it up right to Willie. Open field. He's fighting for it. He's got it. Moving it right up the middle. Dangerous territory. Get it to Ross. Oh, he's got
Ross,
it to Ross.
Excellent pass.
Oh, there we are.
Ross eludes the keeper for the Falcons and able to score the goal. That one's officially a goal.
Finally an official second goal.
So the score now is 2-0, 37 minutes remaining. And speaking of the man with the hot hand, Ross Downey, second goal of the game for him.
Ross is on fire for home games this season. Certainly shows his character. He hardly did a celebration dance, and he's right back at it.
Something about this home Alumni Memorial Field grass. Maybe Ross is partial to it.
Think he might.
Somehow.
Just a different energy about this field, that's for sure.
I think also the homecoming environment, you know, might add a little pep in the step of the Bengal players.
Absolutely.
Putting on, you know, representing the community, representing the town of Fort Kent.
We have a pretty good showing. Plenty of locals out today, along with students.
As the Falcons now really really are going to have to step their game up offensively. They finally let a crack in their defense, but they're going to have to try and make a response here if they want to come back and make this a ball game again. It's currently 2-0, 36 minutes left to go. Ross Downey. From Edinburgh, Scotland, home of a famous castle.
Edinburgh Castle. All right, we're bringing it back to the Falcons side. Steven bringing it up the right side. Trying for Willie. Willie coming in hot.
Called for offsides again. Willie just cannot stay from being offsides.
Penalties are plaguing us. Yeah, we still hold the lead, so. Ooh. Bengals swarming. Ben trying to turn this luck around. Really do have a great defense this year.
Oh, yeah. We've got some strong defensive players, and one of our top defenders, Phil Dion, is on the IR with a foot injury. So, like I said earlier, it's that next man up mentality that's really a strength for the Bengals. They have a deep roster,
no doubt.
And even when a guy who usually gets a lot of minutes is out, the next guy is right there to step up and get the job done.
Mm-hmm. Phil watching intently on the sidelines. I'm sure he wishes he could be in today.
Stuart Conway on that far corner. Ooh. Makes one defender slip and fall.
He's out there breaking ankles. He's got those moves. And into the pucker brush.
Jamie Reed looks to get it in. Gonna go for the cross here. A low ball kicked up in the air by Fisher. Steven into the corner for Kalusha. See if he can make something happen. Oh, nice defense there by the Falcons. Deflect that one and keep it in bounds. And they're on the offensive.
Ooh.
They're making it some advancements.
Up. Excellent slide.
Ben Kluver's with the slide tackle. Knocks that one out of bounds as the Bengals retain possession.
Kalusha trying to bring it across. Can he keep it inside?
He's in the Ooh. Shade over there.
Back to Stewart.
I find it fascinating that only a very small portion of the field is in shade. Over there, kind of towards the scoreboard, there's some nice greenery.
Mm-hmm.
As we got our first substitution of the second half, for the Bengals, Justin Suntian's entering the game.
Number 11.
I believe, Willie Monte.
It is 60 degrees on this crisp autumn day, zero humidity, and it is perfect soccer weather.
Definitely.
Nobody's cold. They're all staying limber, but nobody's sweating like the last few games we've had here.
As Rodney's advancement wasn't quite there. As I mentioned, Justin recently inserted into the game.
Making some moves.
His sister, Cassandra, member of our women's team. And Justin's in control of the ball. We've got a foul, and a yellow card.
The yellow card is out on the field.
Has been given out to Steven Al-Said, the freshman. I think he had a little bit of a disagreement.
Ross trying to.
With the official.
Be a mentor to his teammate.
Ross doing his best to mediate.
Now, how old is Steven?
I'm not quite sure how old he is, but he's definitely a freshman.
A young guy, he's got a career ahead of him, so.
Youngster, yeah. He's got a lot of potential. He gets a lot of playing time for Coach Ashby. And it's only his first year. So he has the potential to be a great player in Bengals history.
No doubt, no doubt. Stewart trying to keep it on his shady corner there. I think that's Ross way off in the distance. Ooh, and Ross goes down.
Wind starting to pick up here at Alumni Memorial Field.
So
but
we
it's
have a
still quite a pleasant day for soccer on this homecoming weekend.
Absolutely. Nice breeze rolling through. And a corner kick by, I believe that's Jamie way out there.
Jamie Reed out there in the shade. This is the final event for this wonderful homecoming weekend that the university has put on for the community here, the community and the alumni.
Be nice if we could cap it off with a win.
Definitely. Two wins on this homecoming Sunday would be a great thing.
Indeed it would.
The women did their job, took care of business 11-0.
Indeed they did.
You don't see many soccer games reach double-digit scoring, but
no, you don't.
That just shows the firepower that the Lady Bengals have.
They certainly do. They're looking to have another great season, no doubt.
And now the men are in charge here, 2-0, 29 minutes left in this first half.
Ooh, firing right at the goal. Falcons goalkeeper there per usual. He responds with a boot. Looks like Odine has this one. But it's Stewart to Steven. Ooh, Soutine's moving in. Keeping his footing.
Justin took a spill there, but he showed tremendous hustle. Thing I like about Justin's game, man, he's a scrappy player. Toughness would be the word I would use to describe.
Definitely nice little bear crawl right there.
His family came down from Canada this weekend to check him out. Shout out to Justin's family.
Ooh, somebody goes down upfield. I believe that's Ben Kluvers, the veteran.
The vet. El Capitan, as I like to call him. He's from Vernon Hills, Illinois. So he's got that nice Midwest personality about him.
No doubt.
And he's a real pro out there. You know, he's a leader.
Yep.
Whenever I watch them practice, he's always motivating the guys. He's keeping them going.
Pleasant character, no doubt.
Yeah. You can't help but like the guy. He's a junior, I believe. So he's got one more year to show, you know, to make it count here in Fort Kent.
And he certainly looks as though he's got the tenacity to keep up the pace. I'd like to see him get a chance to score in this one. I'm sure it'd do a lot for his confidence right now. Starting out for a slow season for Ben. All right, Steven, freshman, bringing it up right in the middle. He's in shooting territory. To Soutines on the side, moving it up to the middle. Right over Ross's head.
And we've got a substitution for the Bengals.
Looks
like we are bringing on Sparky.
Sparky Petrovic.
Fan favorite. If Nico was here, I'm sure he'd be able to pronounce his whole name, but...
Sparky Petrovic from Serbia coming in for Kalusha. Kalusha's done an excellent job so far in this game.
No doubt.
And I'm sure Sparky will be able to keep the pace going.
The Falcons goes down, but he's getting up. Looks like he'll walk it off.
Time's winding down on the Falcon attack here.
Still 26 minutes left in the game. And the Bengals remain in control.
They're dominating time of possession.
No doubt.
Not letting the Falcons get too many chances.
Justin, back to his scrapping abilities. There he goes. Right up to Rodney. Rodney to Steven. And rolls out of bounds.
Justin, nice cross to Ross.
Ross with the head. And
the header is good.
Goal, 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 goal.
What a phenomenal pass.
Brilliant.
From absolutely. Justin Suntiens.
Justin, once again, finally gets his just desserts, and that would be a brilliant assist.
Brilliant assist to the hat trick from Ross Downey. That's goal number 3. Hats off to you, Ross.
And the crowd here at Fort Kent cheering for Justin.
Live in full effect.
Ross doesn't seem to mind. He looks like he's floating on air. It's his hat trick.
As we got another substitution into the game, Milton Christopher in for Ben Kluvers. What a remarkable pass that was.
Absolutely.
He just floated it right up there in prime header land, and Ross was able to get the job done.
I heard it's nice in header land. Yep. Pretty nice this time of year.
Ross certainly seems to think so.
Absolutely. All right, Steven bringing up the middle. This usually spells out good things. It's not quite Scotland Yard, but we got the Canadian Justin Soutines fighting for it. Odin backpedaling, trying to keep with it, and he's got this one. And the Bengals remain in control.
Odin is there to negate any thought of a Falcon attack.
Absolutely, no swooping in today.
Some chippiness going on. Foul on the Falcons.
Ooh. We've got a whole swarm of black and green here. Once again, Steve doesn't seem to be running out of gas.
No, his conditioning is in tip-top shape.
No doubt.
Oh, nice ball from Rodney. Sparky.
Oh, Sparky bringing it up.
Open net.
Oh!
Got him!
And he connects.
The fan favorite Sparky bringing it in.
4-0. Bengals in charge. 23 minutes left to go. It seems as though this Falcon defense, which did such an outstanding, well, pretty good job in the first half, definitely starting to slip up a bit. I think that the endurance and the conditioning for UMFK is just that much better than that of the Falcons.
Definitely. These guys are serious athletes.
The substitutions for Coach Ashby have paid off. Like I said, the energy level never drops with the substitutions.
No, sir.
And seeing as that the Bengals have a very deep and talented roster, I think that's been the difference here in this game, as the Falcons have... maybe they're slowing down a bit. The keeper for the Falcons is, without a doubt, had his hands full.
This whole game.
The entire match.
Oof. These guys are certainly starting to look like a unit. Touch passes all around. Everybody's getting some time and eluding this Falcon defense here. It's really been something else. Oh, here comes Jamie with the shot. Oh, just off the post.
Jamie Reed went for it all with a strike from almost 30 yards out. A bit off the mark.
Not too far. Better luck next time, Jamie. Sparky's fighting for it. Stewart right there with him. And the Falcons just unable to penetrate this titanium defense the Bengals are working with. Steve kicks it out of bounds. In down the right sideline and out again.
The throw in from the Falcons was thrown right back out of bounds as the Bengals get the ball back. Stuart Conway on the far side. Ross Downey.
Bringing it up the middle. Here we are. We got Rodney keeping it in play. Steve on the outside trying to bring it across, and it is kicked out of bounds.
Substitution time for the Bengals. Entering the game is Ricardo and Kyle Robin. Exiting the game are Tom Coxon and Rodney. One last substitution, Jesse Shelton into the game for... Nope, false alarm. Jesse Shelton... We'll wait at the scores table over there.
Jesse certainly looks rearing and ready to go, but he may have to wait a little bit longer. We have 20 minutes left in this impeccable matchup.
Kyle Robin looking to put it into play. Lofts up a nice cross.
Ooh, beautiful.
Couldn't find the mark.
Jamie Reed's trying to bring it back. Got a perfect triangle.
Stewart.
Home run out of bounds.
Here we go. There's that substitution that last substitution I was talking about.
And
entering the game, Mr. Jesse Shelton.
And Steve of Edinburgh exits. Is he of Edinburgh? Where is Steve?
I don't believe Stephen Alsay.
Never mind, he's from Bonnybridge, Scotland. Sorry.
Bonnybridge. Sorry to all our listeners in Edinburgh and Bonnybridge.
We're trying to familiarize ourselves with Scotland, the country that so many of our great players are from. Of course, Ross, being the major contributor in this game, is from Edinburgh, so my apologies. Ooh, it's getting rough right in the middle.
Kyle lofts it up. Stuart Conway into the nope, that's Sparky into the shade.
Oh.
And he is...
The goalie goes down.
Dragged down by the keeper.
He was not getting away with that one.
The keeper was going to do whatever it took for Sparky not to have that open net.
And somebody's down over there for the Falcons.
An accident by the keeper for the Falcons, accidentally injuring his own teammate. So Sparky's going to go with this this penalty kick here to see if he can knock it in.
For his second goal of the day.
It would potentially be his second goal of the day. We got a pause in the action as our trainer, Andrea, comes out to check on the injured Falcon. Shout out to Andrea. She's been doing an excellent job as a trainer so far this year. She's new to Fort Kent Athletics this season.
She's had a busy season this year.
Busy. She's been busy so far. She's been thrown into the fire.
Yep.
But she's handled it gracefully. And looks like that Falcon's going to be okay. Here's Sparky with the penalty kick.
This one's well-deserved. Dragged down by the goalie just moments ago. Sparky gets his revenge.
Tee it up.
There it is.
He finds the right corner of the net for the score. Sparky. Goal number two.
We have some speculation from the stands, maybe a double hat trick today.
Potentially. We had one in the women's game with Alex and Catherine Ferland. Let's see if we can get one here. Before we move on, though, I just want to make sure I give a shout-out to Sparky's family listening in Serbia. Sparky lets me know that they are always listening, so shout-out to them. Another substitution for the Bengals. Exiting the game is Ross Downey. Entering the game Sean Nystrom.
Sean getting some playing time today. See if he can change things up. Fresh pair of legs.
And it's not like Ross is being subbed out for anything wrong he did. He's had a heck of a game with the hat trick today. He's been all over the field.
I'd say he deserves some rest.
Sparky fighting for it out over there in the shade, the shady far left corner of the field. Kind of underneath our scoreboard of Alumni Memorial Field. It won't be long until the sun sets on this beautiful Sunday and our entire field is covered in shade.
This is true. It's turning into autumn in Maine. Sun will be setting, earlier every day.
Jesse with a
beautiful
strike.
Beautiful strike.
A leaping save from the keeper of Fisher College.
We need to get that guy's name. He's had one hell of a game. Apart from pulling Sparky down, of course. But we can let that go. Ooh. Kyle of Glasgow, Scotland, putting that back into play. Ricardo's fighting for it.
Jesse,
ooh.
Another strike. The keeper for the Falcons is on the ground.
Keeping the keeper on his toes, no doubt. Oh, little collision. Certainly testing the gall of our players today. Been a very physical match.
Falcons here with the ball, looking to make something happen. Looking to try and get on the board here. 15 minutes left in the second half.
Got some fancy footwork from the Falcons.
A do-si-do by a Fisher College player.
Indeed. Oh, there's not quite a shot. Good cross.
The cross and number one of the Falcons couldn't quite connect. Another sub for the Bengals. Sparky exiting the game and Ashley entering the game. He's getting some minutes here in homecoming weekend. Ashley coming all the way to Fort Kent. From South Africa.
Jonesburg.
Johannesburg.
Johannesburg, there it is.
Johannesburg, South Africa, which is one of the most populated cities in South Africa. So currently, continents that are being represented on the field for the Bengals include... Hold on, I'll get to that in a second. We got some subs. Who do we got here? We've got... I think we've got Kamar getting some minutes. And we've got Louis the 16th getting some time.
Oh, yes.
Odine has exited the game.
He had an excellent day on defense.
He was holding it down defensively.
Stopping numerous attempts and keeping our goalie as lazy as possible. Ashley fighting for it in the shady corner.
As Davian Glenn has also entered the game. So Coach Ashby has fully utilized his reserves today. Homecoming weekend, he thought, looks like this game, you know, we're in charge of this game. I'm going to let my starters get some rest for the next match, the next upcoming match, and I'm going to let the full squad get some love today. So as I was saying, continents being represented on the field by the Bengals today include North America, Europe, and Africa.
Yeah.
And if you want to count the Caribbean as maybe...
We can say Central. Maybe
Central or South America, you can count them too. So we're going to go three, potentially four continents being represented. We've got Canada, Scotland, South Africa... and Jamaica.
Very worldly team here.
Global. Certainly. Oh, we've also got America, but that's part of North America.
Indeed it is.
So it is a international...
Of course, us Americans are not that... not known for our geography skills, hence the Jonesburg, Africa, South Africa.
Shout out to South Africa. Sorry for screwing that up.
Yeah, that's Johannesburg.
Johannesburg.
Heard the architecture there's a lot like Boston, actually. Heard it's a beautiful city.
Really?
Well, the whole country.
Milton's all over that one, negating any hope of a Falcon advancement.
Kyle Robbins bringing it right up the middle. He's looking for Justin.
Nice cross. Keeper for the Falcons intercepts it. He sends it back across the field.
Speaking of Boston, it does not look as though these guys are going to be bringing home a win to their native Massachusetts.
No, the Fisher Falcons, although there's 11 minutes left in the game.
A lot can happen in 11 minutes. There's no doubt about that.
Hope is dwindling.
We've got yellow and green swarming by the goal here. Corner kick, no good. Kyle Robbins getting that right out of there.
Falcons in the matching... navy blue shorts and tops.
They look like brothers.
Justin crosses it into the shade for Ashley. He tracks it down. Let's see what he can do. Crosses it back to midfield.
This ball's getting some air time today. Ooh. And there's a whistle.
Sean and Justin getting tangled up. A foul is called. 10 minutes remaining in this second half. The score is currently 5-0. Bengals in charge. We want to thank you guys again for tuning into this Bengal Vision live webcast.
Absolutely.
Here in homecoming weekend at the University of Maine at Fort Kent. We're in the booth live at Alumni Memorial Field, bringing you the second game of our doubleheader 100% live. In case you missed it, the Lady Bengals were the first game of this doubleheader. They defeated the Fisher College Falcons by a score of 11-0. Yes, you heard that right. 11-0.
That's basketball score as well. All right, more like football.
That's definitely an American football score.
It's an American football score right there.
Maybe they were, you know, it is Sunday. NFL season's in full swing. Maybe they were inspired by
they're feeling
some
it.
Football. Louis the 16th weaving in and out of defenders. Call him Louis the 16th because his name is Louis and he wears number 16.
Mm-hmm. Good friends with Steve, number 17.
Louis Temple, a.k.a. Louis the 16th, a freshman from Edinburgh, Scotland.
Hopefully he keeps that number throughout his years here at UMFK.
I think that's a great nickname for him. You know, another nickname that I came up with, although he's no longer on the field, Rodney Witter. He's dangerous when he's got the ball.
Absolutely.
He's, you know, anything could happen. So I decided to call him Rodney Dangerfield.
Rodney Dangerfield.
I can't believe I forgot about that.
Iconic.
Can't believe I forgot to mention that while he was on the field. Must have slipped my mind. But
well, sometimes these things happen.
Rodney Dangerfield. That's another nickname I came up with.
UMFK starters had one hell of a first half here.
They certainly did a tremendous job as the score is 5-0, 7.5 minutes left in the game. Ashley to Kyle. Justin on this right side to Jesse. Surveying. Ricardo, nice job of getting that ball away from the Falcon opponent.
Jesse to Justin, moving it out. Home territory. Oop. Falcon certainly still giving it their all. There's no quitting them.
I like to see that. At this level of competitive soccer, that even when down 5-0, there's no quit. They're looking to get a score on the board. And the Bengals are doing their best at trying to stop that from happening. The competition here is high. The passion is high.
Shutout certainly would mean a lot after that tough West Virginia game.
Definitely.
Last week.
If both men and women's team Bengal teams could come up with shutouts on homecoming weekend, that would be
ideal.
A tremendous feat.
Absolutely. Sean goes down, but he's back up. Oof. Jesse looking for a crossover, looking for Sean.
Keeper for the Falcons hits the deck, trying to save that one.
Mm-hmm.
Successful dive in keeping that ball from finding the net.
Justin with a boot. Looking for Louis. Ricardo not letting the Falcons pass.
You shall not pass.
Here comes Kyle. Kick to no one in particular. Oh, and here it is.
The first time in it seems like ages, our keeper is holding the ball.
That's Alex Charette, who's been in goal all game today. He's a Fort Kent native.
Is he new to the team?
He's a new addition to the roster this year. It's great that Alex could be out here representing Fort Kent in this homecoming weekend.
No doubt. These guys
have some undeniable synergy. I mean, they're playing off each other. So.
Without a doubt. It's got to be special for Alex to represent his hometown on the field here today, especially with the community having his back and the whole, you know, homecoming, all the alumni, all the townsfolk who showed their support during our pep rally and our parade throughout downtown Fort Kent.
Yeah, that was a good parade. I like that. Nice for all the athletes to join us as well.
It's the least we could do, Curran. As an athlete, I speak for all of us athletes when I say we really appreciate the support that the community is, bestows upon us. We don't always get a chance to thank them, but this was a great opportunity. This weekend was a nice chance for us to give our thanks.
Certainly is a unique atmosphere to just allow all these athletes to really, improve and show off their skills with this craft that they've been working on their whole lives. So.
Kyle looking like he's taking the corner kick out from the shady corner there.
Corner kick, Kale Robin.
Yes, sir.
A little bit low.
Bouncing in and scooped up by the keeper, the Falcons. He's been putting in some work today. There's no doubt about that. Oof. Header missed. Ricardo to Kyle. Or Jesse, rather. Jesse trying to bring it up. To Louis. Louis still fighting for it. Justin has
Milton
another chance
to Justin.
Here, and it's in.
Excellent pass. Justin with the score. That guy must be on cloud nine right now.
That's right. First goal for Justin this game. He had an assist earlier with one of Ross's goals.
He did. He entered this game off the bench, but he's definitely made a strong contribution today. He didn't get caught up in the offsides trap that the Falcons had been on today earlier in the game. Excellent assist from Milton. Should not go without being mentioned.
Absolutely. Milton is all over the place playing some good defense.
And he just lofted that one up, put it perfect position for Justin to knock that in. Just under a minute remaining. The score is 6-0.
Clock rapidly winding down.
As the clock winds down, I think the chances of winning or any comeback are winding down for the Falcons.
Mm-hmm. No doubt about that. Looks as though the Bengals look pretty satisfied with their performance. Everybody's still playing their part, but they're definitely walking with their shoulders back and their heads high.
Well, I'd say the jello's jiggling. The fat lady's warming up, and you can put the kids to sleep on this one.
Yes, sir.
Bengals soccer, homecoming weekend, a combined 17 goals scored, 0 goals allowed in only 2 games. An outstanding weekend.
And we
thank you for tuning in to this webcast. It's been a pleasure to bring it to you live. Please tune in for more games. Have a tremendous Sunday evening. Signing off, Fletcher Brown.
Curran Lacombe signing off as well.
Peace be unto you.
Yes. Have a good one.